even what we're all here for. You just said it, right? International Workers Day, right? ¿Para qué estamos aquí hoy día, mi gente? Lo acabamos de decir, ¿verdad? Para el Día Internacional del Trabajador. Hoy estamos aquí con mucho amor y mucho orgullo para celebrar y festejar y dar gracias a todos los trabajadores en esta bella ciudad, en este bello estado y en todo el mundo, celebrando el Día Internacional de los Trabajadores.
We are here today to lift our voices and voice our demands in unity across language barriers, across age gaps, across sectors, to march and step together for International Workers Day.
Hoy estamos aquí de muchas diferentes comunidades, hablamos muchos diferentes idiomas, somos de muchas diferentes edades, ¿verdad? Pero todos estamos aquí para la misma cosa, para levantar la voz y la dignidad de los trabajadores. Y sabemos que la mejor manera de dar gracias a los trabajadores es reconociendo su dignidad y su trabajo, ¿cierto? Reconociendo los derechos que tienen y los derechos que estamos luchando.
And this year, migrant communities and the May 1st Planning Committee have worked very hard to put together points of unities and a theme to highlight migrants against state repression.
Este año, los organizadores de este evento, escuchando a toda la comunidad, hemos trabajado muy duro, ¿verdad?, para levantar ciertos puntos que es nuestra visión, nuestra misión es levantar que los migrantes estamos aquí en contra de la represión estatal.
My name is Tina Schaaf. I'm with Gabriela's USA, and this is.
Y yo soy Ariana Chila Farrate con Mujeres Unidas y Activas.
And we are very honored to be your MCs on this beautiful day to honor workers.
I grew up asking my mother why. Does God forsake us? Let the evil ones take us. Diosito no hizo esto. Fueron los hombres y corazón. Por eso ella me enseñó compasión. Y me dijo, hijo mío, tú eres mi otro yo. Is what she replied. I always knew in my heart that my teachers told me lies. That I was dumb. My people died south of fishing backwards and criminals and zoos. Far from the truth. No wonder we created original threads. Zoot, zoot. In addition to that, we tattooed our skins, painted on community walls like ancient bibliography, depicted through hieroglyphs how we used to live, how we used to love, how we continue to sacrifice the I so our children could one day thrive. This is the legacy of the hummingbird tattoo, because I don't do this for the dead presidents. I do this for ancestors that are among the stars of residents. That's that one. Yo. Pencil pad, no fat, set trends to mend wounds. From tears sealed off the backs of my black and brown fam. Scholar and the activist, Einstein, intellect, blue collar like my father, strap of prayers. Left hand, the reins. Riding out the San Joaquin Valley plains. The pain in my veins until I DS land like planes. And LAX, and gain respect from knowledge stored in my brain to attain freedom like runaway slaves. Breaking the code, curse chain. Coyote howls, soaring like owls, soaring like eagles, and chilling like seagulls at the dock of the bay. Mastering my craft like sages, reaching master stages. Magic when the ink runs dry. Yo, y'all still with me? Y'all still with me? Cause we ride for dignity till infinity. We ride for dignity till infinity. Porque si justicia, sin justicia, no justice. No justice! Yo, I chose love. I chose us. I chose to follow the instructions of my mother, so peace to my foremothers, implacable warriors. Taught me the bow, so I know, nod my arrows. Rock for judge, rock for dignity, staying tall like Egyptian pharaohs. Peace to real G's, real MC's, from this young poet. 32 focus in the middle path in motion. Seek it, understand to be a master of ceremonies. Separated from the phony, showing times is quiet, homie, but it's never lonely. Missing my ancestors, but they ride with me in spirit. Telling me I had to be an agent of change for the children. Demons show me limits, the most high happiness and freedom. Given my circumstances, I'm a late bloomer. All good, cause I got a good sense of humor. 7 years struggling, community college, two low wage jobs. Son of a born to perseverance. Building kitchen so my feet can inherit knowledge itself. Split book and spit truth. Peace to all indigenous, especially all of you. Peace. Thank you.
Thank you, Ray. Please give Ray a round of applause.
Thank you for some of the infrastructure and everybody else. We have a lot of unions, a lot of community groups, a lot of faith groups on the stage today, and we have a lot of things that we're working on. We just passed the Retail Worker Bill of Rights, which is going to help union and non-union workers here in San Francisco. We have the highest minimum wage. Today is May 1st. Minimum wage goes to $12.25 in San Francisco for all workers, and it's going to get to $15 an hour, and then there's going to be the cost of living on there. It's because of labor and community and faith groups that put this together, as well as our friends in the legislature, as well as City Hall. And I just want to thank everybody for being there. The San Francisco Labor Council celebrates this day of action for immigrant workers and all workers. And thank you all for coming out. And are we going to have a good day? No justice? No justice? No justice? Thank you.
Thank you, Tim. Well, muchas gracias a Tim. Ahora queremos invitar a Bernadette Herrera del grupo Migrante, que nos va a estar hablando de la migración forzada, ¿verdad? Porque nadie... No, no.
But we deserve rights. Please welcome Bernadette.
Thank you, Latina.
Pero la cosa es de que las propuestas...
Pangalan sa pagbati sa inyong lahat mula sa Migrante Northern California. Good afternoon, everyone from Migrante Northern California. Nandito na rin lahat para i-celebrate ang araw ng manggagawa. I-celebrate dahil kilalanin natin ang ating mga tagumpay mula nang tayo'y nagkaisa. Mag-celebrate dahil pinakita natin ang ating pagkakaisa, ang ating militanteng pagkilos para makabisati ng ating mga tagumpay.
We are here to celebrate International Workers' Day until victory and until we are all united to fight for our victory.
Hindi nangyay sa inyo ang mga Pilipino ay nasa katatulok ng mundo. Lahat ng Pilipino ay nasa iba't ibang bansa sapagkat hindi po namin ito ginusto. Ito ay dahil sa kalagayan ng mga Pilipino sa Pilipinas, dahil sa kahirapan, dahil patuloy na naghihirap ang mamayang Pilipino sa Pilipinas.
We are here today to speak about the Filipinos who are in all corners of the world. And the reason why we are in all corners of the world, and land and sea, is because of the conditions, the corrupt conditions in the Philippines.
Araw-araw, may 6,000 na umaalis sa Pilipinas. Mahigit 10% ng Pilipino ay nasa labas ng bansa. 4 milyon ay nasa Estados Unidos. 1 milyon undocumented. Kaya po kami nandito, umaalis ng bansa dahil sa kahirapan. Ngunit dahil kami sabihin sa inyo, kung maganda ang buhay sa Pilipinas, sana ay nandun kami. Pero ano ang kapalit na aming dinadanas dito sa Amerika? Sa kasalukuyan, patuloy na napakababa ng sahod. Sa araw na ito, 12.25 ang minimum wage ng San Francisco. 7.25 sa federal government, 7.25 lang. Pero hanggang ngayon nananawagan tayong lahat na sana ay tumaas dahil hindi natin masasabing may dignidad
every day. girls leave the Philippines every day. Over 60% of them are women. And we leave our country separating from our families and being in vulnerable conditions so that we are able to gain a wage and send money back home. We will sacrifice our own lives so that we will find livelihood. But we are here today to fight for our own wages, for our own rights, for our own workers' rights. Today it is $12.25 minimum wage here in San Francisco. But we are here to make sure that we are increasing it so that we are able to have a living wage.
Walk down the street with our hands up, without being gunned down by the police. When all these things are happening, we need to rethink our strategies of how we're going to get food. And on the question of freedom, we need to rethink this whole thing about nonviolence. Because Malcolm X teaches us that the only person, the only one who tells you to be nonviolent all the time is the wolf that intends to make you his sheep.
Yes.
And we are tired of this being sheep. We need
yes.
to live. We want our freedom. We want our liberation. We want land. We want bread. We want good housing. We want good education. And we want free health care for all. And we want livable wages for all. Before I end, I want to quote you this thing that this brother in Baltimore had just said. He said, we are ready to retaliate. We're tired. Black power. Black power. Say it with me. Black power.
Black power.
Black power. I want to conclude by quoting the sister who's currently in Cuba. Sister Asada Shakur, a former Black Panther member of the Black Liberation Army, who has currently a $2 million bounty on her head by this government. Please say after me. It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to win.
It is our duty to win.
We must love and protect each other.
We must love and protect each other.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
We have nothing to lose but our chains.
It is our duty to fight for our freedom.
It is our duty to win.
We must love and protect each other.
We have nothing to lose by our chains.
Thank you. All power to the people.
Are the workers here today? Mi nombre es David Campos. Soy el supervisor de la misión y tengo el orgullo de ser un inmigrante.
My name is David Campos, and I have the privilege, the honor of being an immigrant.
Tengo el orgullo de haber sido un inmigrante indocumentado.
I have the honor of having been an undocumented worker.
Can we say we believe that every human being has dignity?
Digamos que cada ser humano tiene dignidad.
Estamos aquí para preguntarle al gobierno que respete los derechos de los inmigrantes.
We are here to ask our government to respect the rights of immigrants.
Estamos aquí para pedir justicia social a todos los trabajadores.
We are here to ask for social justice for our workers.
Estamos aquí no solamente para luchar por el inmigrante, pero también por la persona que está siendo desplazada de la misión.
We are here to not only fight for the immigrant, but also here to fight for the person that is being displaced and evicted from the mission.
We are here. Estamos aquí para luchar en contra de la violencia por parte de la policía.
We are here to talk about what's happening in terms of police brutality.
Y aquí en San Francisco estamos para luchando por los derechos de cada persona.
Here in San Francisco, we are here to fight for the rights of every individual.
La ciudad de San Francisco es una ciudad en crisis. Una ciudad donde la clase trabajadora, la clase media, está siendo desplazada de esta ciudad.
Queremos mandar un mensaje que San Francisco les pertenece a toda la gente, no solo a los millonarios. San Francisco is a city in crisis. It's a city that's pushing out its working class, that is pushing out its middle class. And we are here to say that San Francisco belongs to all of us. San Francisco doesn't just belong to the millionaires. So when I ask you, whose city, I want you to say, our city. Whose city?
Our city.
Whose city?
Our city.
Whose city?
Our city.
Our city. San Francisco belongs to all of us. Thank you so much. Gracias.
Malolele.
Afade. Kia ora.
Kia ora. Hi, everyone. Thank you so much for being here. My name is Laura. We're here at Pacific Islanders. We're workers. We're immigrants. And today we're going to, we want to share with you that we live in this city. Well, actually, I live in Berkeley. You know, but we live in the Bay Area. And we're going to have someone since is going to talk about being born and raised in San Francisco. And we just want everyone to know that we have this war cry in the Pacific because climate change is killing our people. And our war cry is, we're not drowning, we're fighting. And so that's what we want to come here and say. Now I'm going to give the mic to Gaynor. Hello?
My name is Gaynor Siasanga. I was born and raised in San Francisco. I'm not going to tell you how long because then you're going to notice how old I am. But as you can see, like if you're from, how many of you guys are from Frisco? All right, so we already know by looking around there's a lot of changes, right? A lot of changes, and a lot of them don't fit none of us. As being a Pacific Islander, we sit here and we've heard like the newest news, which is going to impact us a lot. Not just us as TIs, but just all of us citywide. Campos had already touched on it a little bit with the gentrification, all these big corporations coming here and building and pushing us out. But now they're trying to prioritize or privatize housing. That means that they're opening up the doors for developers and corporations to buy up our projects. Do we want that?
No!
Reason why it will hit us, like, really bad is the fact that we make up 40% of housing, Pacific Islanders. Sorry. So we make up 40%. That's a large margin, right? We're only a little tiny dot like this on the map. But that's a large margin here in San Francisco. So, yeah, that's what's happening with the Samoans nowadays. And so we're here to stand in unity and solidarity, to continue the fight, stop gentrification. We speak up for stopping the violence, whether it's police brutality or, you know, community violence, whatever the case may be. You guys, sorry, I'm going to bring somebody else up, but just know that we're in the fight too and that we're not going to give up. You're not going to push us out of our home. This is our home and this is where we want to be.
Hampaday mango fair. Man not that ye hit ye sen he lui manam kuna thought ling see ha. Do ye man be nettin' in a sack man see ha. In Tina ye man yin and mommy. That in Tina ye man be nettin' in a thou thou see ha. E thou thou o loni. Nat lot la ye man be nettin' in a thou thou. Nat lot la ye thou thou o loni.
Karusa! Karusa! Kamlo!
to the honors, I also just want to thank the Ohlone of this land. Thank you.
She left, and then worship, and then this July, this past July, when she was just coming and planning a trip to come to Hawaii with her 6-year-old daughter, she was arrested at the airport in an operation that involved Interpol, Customs and Border Protection, Honolulu Police Department, Yolo County Child Abduction Unit, and ICE. This is because while she was away, her boyfriend reported her to the police for child abduction. So for 9 months, she was held in jail without a fair trial, and she was just convicted of child abduction as a victim of domestic violence. And as soon as she was released from jail, she was picked up from ICE right from the lobby, right from the waiting room of the jail. So for us, this just demonstrates some of the ways that domestic violence is also very intertwined with state violence. And when we talk about state violence, we so often do not talk about violence against women.
This is part of our political movement, and we need to be addressing these issues together as gender violence, detention, incarceration, deportation. All of these things need to be addressed together, because unless all these names and all these stories are lifted up, we're just going to continue perpetrating the same cycles of violence and abuse in our community. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Hidden. Las mujeres siguen, la lucha sigue.
Nowhere. I want y'all to repeat, we ain't going nowhere. We ain't going nowhere.
We ain't going nowhere.
We ain't going nowhere. Alright, cool. I see my block start to change. Move us out with evictions enforced by the police and the nasty dispositions. Techie startups taking pieces of the mission. Techie startups make a killing. Killer cops drop us. Media no listen. Try to break us down as soon as we start building. They want us gone from the get-go. Rest in power to Alex Nieto. Rest in power to every life we had to let go. To state violence, applying this divide and conquer shit. I've seen it in the very same place that my ancestors walked. Colonizer on your land, gentrifier on your block. And police to police on the streets, he's up, but it don't fucking stop. And Uber and Google, no matter how frugal, the rent won't fucking drop. And fuck all these prices, and fuck all these devices. Trying to make ends meet, not living in the streets, and I don't eat meat, but I got beef, and at times it's kinda hard not to turn violent when they kick us off our blocks, and I start to slaying rocks. Bastardize our food, claim society poster racing. They don't want us to learn our roots, they want us assimilating. Hipsters wearing headdresses saying they're trying to be fun. Funny, that's what I said when I had his head against my gun. We ain't going nowhere.
We ain't going nowhere.
My mama, pop, my sister's on the block. We going nowhere. We ain't going nowhere.
We ain't going nowhere.
My allies, comrades, brothers, we going nowhere. Thank you very much, y'all. Free the land, free Palestine. Happy May Day.
Thank you, Sarit. And we're going to say, free Palestine and the occupation. Free Palestine and the occupation. Free Palestine and the occupation. Free Palestine and the occupation.
Now we know when state repression happens, repression breeds resistance, right? So when I say repression, you say breeds resistance. Repression
breeds resistance.
Repression
breeds resistance.
So no matter how much repression they put upon us, we will not stop until we achieve victory. Is that right?
Yeah.
That's right. We're going to continue fighting. So
esto. Nosotros sabemos que hay mucha represión hoy en día, ¿verdad? Pero también sabemos que la represión crea la rebeldía. Entonces hoy vamos a seguir luchando. Entre más represión nos pongan, más nos vamos a rebelar. Ahorita queremos invitar a Chirac Bastá de la colaborativa de hoteles de residencia en la Misión y de la colaboración de la Plaza 16.
And next we have Chirag Bakta from Plaza 16 and Mission SRO Collaborative. Please welcome him.
Thank you, thank you. On top of that, I am born and raised in the Tenderloin, right up the block. But today, on International Workers' Day, I am here as a proletarian, as a child of immigrants, and as someone who has had enough, I have had enough of the capitalist class exploiting my peoples, our peoples, all over the planet, from sweatshops in Bangladesh, to factories in Colombia, to mines in South Africa, to office buildings in San Francisco. I have had enough of the capitalist class pillaging this earth and its resources at the expense of our survival and the destruction of indigenous communities. I've had enough of the capitalist class, the venture capitalists, the tech billionaires buying this city, buying that building, buying our Bay Area in order to make their dreamed up segregated society. I've had enough of this city doing nothing to stem the onslaught of gentrification, displacement, and the abuse of labor. This city has done nothing to protect the assets of the people. They've only gone out of their way to protect the assets of the rich. We live in the most affluent city, in the most affluent nation, yet we have the second most highest income inequality in the country, in this city. This city has done nothing to stop the forced exodus of many people of color. I know today is International Workers' Day, but it is vital to recognize the intersectionality of our struggles, and that labor justice is nothing without racial justice. The African American population in this city has gone down to single digit percentages. That is a shame. Latino families and individuals are being forced out of the Mission every single day. This city has done nothing. This city, my city, is run by fascists. Yes, I said it. They are fascists. And I ain't gonna hold back. Not today. This is May Day. Fascism when you see it, and I see it every single day in that building. And that is why we are here today, here to rally, here to march, because we oppose the exploitation of people. We oppose the exploitation of our community. And that is why we will come back next week, May 8th, that building, City Hall, 12 noon, to speak truth to those whose power only exists if we allow them to have it. To take over our City Hall for the people, for the marginalized, for the criminalized, for the gentrified. We will take over that building next week, May 8th. Please join us. We need to stop the eviction. stop the displacement of the working class and the people of color of this city, of whatever city you came from around the area. It is happening everywhere. We must draw a line in the sand. If they take away the sand, draw a line in whatever the fuck is left. Enough is enough. We will demand housing for the workers who make this city run and who can and will shut this city down. We will not be shut out. This is our movement. This is our struggle. The power elite next week, May 8th, in that building, will come face to face with the people.
Muchas gracias. Thank you so much.
Give the enemy support and support everything that the enemy opposes, y'all. You hear me? I'm talking to y'all. I've been here for 3 generations. My name is Queen Nandi, and we are part of Pope Poets of Poor Magazine, baby.
Pope's in the house.
And we are also teachers at the Academy School. So we teach our babies to be revolutionary warriors just like us. Let me hear it, y'all. I am here, and I stand here in solidarity, and I stand here to support all workers, from the mama workers at home, to the daddies, to the officers, to the janitors, to the bar workers, Walmart, McDonald's, sex workers, everybody. Because if you're working, you are contributing to making this world a beautiful place. And we don't need no boss that's going to sit up there and take all our money while we do all the work. Now, today is that day. Do y'all hear me?
So we're gonna bless it up real quick if we want to start the march. Simplemente quiero compartir un poquito de poema, ¿verdad? Como migrante de Michoacán, de México, a todas las madres, a los inmigrantes que estamos aquí, ¿verdad? Este es un país de migrantes y la verdad, como dijo la compañera, qué chulada se mira de verdad, raza, qué bonita se mira la gente ahorita. I'm gonna show you peace, it's called the American Dream. ¿Cuál es el pinche sueño americano? El mismo sueño que todos oímos, pero poco logramos. El mismo sueño que tiene a tanta gente viniendo. El mismo sueño que tiene a tanta gente muriendo. A veces pienso y no comprendo. ¿Cuál es el pinche sueño americano? What is the American dream? Families risking their life for the American dream. The same dream they all hear about, but only a few of us get to see. The same dream that so many people coming to hear. The same dream the America lets you see. The same dream that kills hundreds of people every year. Sometimes they're thinking, I can't figure what the dream is. What kind of dream will make you risk your life to jump over the wall to chase that dream? They're so hard to find. ¿Cuál es el pinche sueño americano? ¿Cuál es el pinche sueño americano?
So we're going to eat a little bit of peace, but I'm going to say, what day is this? What day? Who are poor workers in the house? All of us! So we're going to pick it up to our Fabinati centipede for Paul Paul and the welfare queen!
Free the land, free the people, damn it! This poem is called World Workers' Compensation. Indigenous ambitions and survival traditions weren't created by the stroke of a colonizer's pen. False racist laws never existed in equality in humanity's flow. We were born with the knowledge to handle Mama Nature with care as you would a newborn. To work in the land in the name of capitalism, broken bodies fall at the feet of one greedy wealth hoarder. The world's workers' compensation is not the vision of finally retiring at the age of 70, but to create balance, love, and hard work, and the right to celebrate your harvest. We are being marked for death by the agents of the state, because in our loss comes the bulldozers that will rewrite our sacred histories and histories. And your day off today was with pay, because it sure is hard to work for, to make a hell of dice for somebody other than ourselves.
All right! Woo! So first of all, I'm standing here for the Ohlone people upon whose land we are standing. There are no such thing as borders.
mamas. And so my piece is short. I am talking about my mama, a black Indian mama, for without whom there would be no me, a mama so dead and a welfare queen. I'm a poverty scholar. All the people, I'm a poverty scholar, criminalized, racialized, and always in struggle for $1. I am a poverty scholar. All the people you don't want to see, never want to be, look away from me. What you gonna do? Arrest me? I'm in your city. I am a poverty scholar, and I rock this jailhouse attire. Because me and my poor mama did jail time just trying to stay alive in this holler. I am a poverty scholar. I am the colonizer's skin of a melanin-filled mama. A mama soltera and a welfare queen. And I want to say I love all of us workers, because without the workers there won't be no peace in Estados Unidos. Thank you very much, Poor Magazine! Oh, and lastly, if you want to help us criminalize the gentrifiers and the landlords who keep kicking our families and our babies out on the street, join us on May 8th at the District Attorney's Office, 850 Bryant, at 10 a.m. as we open charges of elder abuse against these real estate snakes who keep evicting our elders. Thank you very much.
Thank you, poor poets. Give them another round of applause.
For 3 years now at the City College of San Francisco. How many of you have went to the City College of San Francisco? Raise your hand! Raise your hand! Well, I gotta tell you, there used to be 80,000 people who went to City College of San Francisco. And you know what? Now there's only 60,000. And you know why? Because they've been trying to close it down for a couple of years now. But we have not let that happen. It has been a struggle to keep it open, and it's going to be there for all of us. All working class people need the right to an education.
Yeah.
Save City College. Yeah. Save City College. Save City College.
Save City College.
The struggle that's been going on at City College have connected all of us in this community. It's connected the students to the workers at City College. They've now got us working at 3.5% less money than we were making in 2007. We're not going to take it anymore. We need a decent wage to live in one of the most expensive places in the whole damn world. We need to stand together to make sure that City College of San Francisco stays open, that the workers get what they need, that the students can get the programs they need. Because let me tell you, there's some sad facts going on about what has happened to those people who are not going to City College. We're looking and they're saying, well, maybe they're going over to Laney, or maybe they're going to San Mateo. Guess what? No evidence of that. So where are they going? Where are they going? You know where they're going right now? They're going nowhere. They're losing their opportunity that is the right of everybody to have a chance to do something and make their lives better. Thank you very, very much. Save City College! Save City College! Save City College!
Gracias. Ahora queremos invitar a Chito Cuellar del local 87 a hablarnos de los derechos de los trabajadores inmigrantes. We want to welcome Chito Cuellar from local 87 to talk to us about immigrant worker rights.
Angela is local to the Hotel and Restaurant Union.
Okay, sure.
Over there, truck going.
Thank you.
comunidades. We usually march from the mission to the civic center, where we usually say that that is where power is held. But we recognize today that the power is here, where the people are, where the community is. So this year, we march from the civic center to here, and we are not going anywhere.
Y esto lo hacemos también reconociendo a toda la gente que ha sido desplazada de sus comunidades, que van a regresar, ¿verdad? Regresamos a casa. Ahora, desde aquí de la misión, queremos introducir a nuestra próxima oradora, Milan Sanderson, con
alegría para tocar súper brevemente las razones.
¿Usted? Ok. ¿Ahora puede escucharme?
¡Sí!
Ok, lo siento. Otra vez soy Milan de Careston, soy una abogada que trabajo con los niños y familiares con niños. Y voy a tocar los temas de las fuerzas de inmigración que están empujando a los niños a huir de sus países. Porque en este momento, los números de niños que han salido de sus países y que están entrando a este país, de cuatro países de Centroamérica y México, tres países de Centroamérica y México, los números han sido multiplicados de cuatro desde 2011. Eso significa que en 2011 entraron como 11,000 niños. En 2014, la patrulla fronteriza agarró 60,000 niños. Eso es un número tremendo y estos son niños que están entrando sin sus padres presentes con ellos. Entonces, es obvio que hay un problema que tenemos que pensar. Tenemos que pensar qué está pasando en los países que los niños están corriendo en un número tan grande. Y las Naciones Unidas hicieron una investigación para ver cuáles eran las razones por cuáles los niños están saliendo. Ellos se di cuenta que hay dos razones más comunes, dos tipos de violencia. Uno es violencia en la calle, entonces la violencia de las maras y pandilleros y los carteles, y otro es violencia intrafamiliar. Eso significa la violencia que los niños están encontrando en sus casos por medio de sus propios sangre. Entonces, perdóname, perdí mi pensamiento. Ahora, estos niños están aquí después de haber vencido un montón de obstáculos y están aquí en un país que debe agradecer a estos niños y protegerlos. Y tenemos la oportunidad de protegerlos y guiarlos a ser humanos mejores y buenos. Entonces, tenemos que empujar este país a no ser uno que envía niños a sufrir muertes temprano, porque el mundo está mirándonos en este momento. Tenemos que acordar que los que tengan poder, que los niños están sagrados. Y pues eso es lo que espero que todos nosotros podamos hacer, es empujar a este país a tratar a los niños en una manera decente y honorable. Pues mil gracias. Eso es todo lo que puedo decir. Espero que eso no
sea. Workers from Local 87 FEIU, please welcome them.
Buenas tardes. Happy May Day. Feliz Día del Trabajador. ¿Estamos en la misión o no? No se oye. So por parte de todos los trabajadores de Local 87, the Janitors Union, FEIU Local 87, we want to thank everybody for coming out. I also want to be able to take a moment to thank San Francisco Police Department, who made sure everyone was safe getting here, that was working with us in this march. También quiero reconocer al Departamento de Policía de San Francisco que ayudó en colaborar para que todos llegáramos bien. So we want to be able to thank them. Queremos darle las gracias. And also, we want to be able to remind people, as Parker said, we have a huge fight back campaign. And at 301, the Millennium Building, the financial district, janitors are fighting for their lives to make sure that we can keep jobs that can be dignified, that we can provide for our families. En San Francisco, en el área financiera de San Francisco, están despidiendo trabajadores de Unión. At 630 Samsung, the Department of Homeland Security fired janitors overnight without any notice. They went from being a union company to a non-union contractor. We need to be able to fight for these jobs to be able to remain. There is no community, there is no labor if we have no dignity. No hay comunidad, no hay trabajo si no hay dignidad primero. Y es importante que sigamos ejerciendo ese derecho a través de todas las. Vemos carriolas reaching children on these streets today. We want to make sure that these children can have and continue to call the mission home. Queremos que esta nueva generación de niños que están en las carriolas van a poder crecer en la misión y llamar la misión su hogar también. Thank you very much on behalf of all the janitors of San Francisco. Thank you very, very much. Muchas gracias. There's a chant that we want to make sure all of you guys learn. Hay un canto que se dice, and I'm going to ask you guys to repeat after me. Mama, mama, can't you see? What the boss has done to me. I used to be a human being. Now I'm only a machine. Yeah. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Que vivan los trabajadores. Se puede. Sí se puede.
Thank you. Let's give them a round of applause. So we are also here from various communities. We have folks from the Latino community. Make some noise.
Estamos aquí de muchas diferentes comunidades. Aquí tenemos la comunidad latina presente, ¿cierto?
We have people from the Filipino community. Make some noise.
Gente de la comunidad filipina.
And we have folks, we're just going to say a chant real quick and say, Viva, Viva, Palestina!
Viva, viva, Palestina!
Viva, viva, Palestina! We're also from various communities, some who work with the police and some who don't work with the police.
Estamos aquí de varias comunidades, algunos que trabajamos con la policía y otros que no.
And many of us are here also to make sure that we are keeping our own community safe, because we also know that there's a contradiction in state-sponsored violence.
Pero sabemos que todos los que estamos aquí estamos trabajando para mantener a nuestras comunidades sanas y salvas, porque sabemos que hay una contradicción entre la violencia estatal.
So we're going to say, back up, back up, we want freedom, freedom, all these racist ass cops, we don't need them, need them, just back up, back up, we want freedom, freedom, all these racist ass cops, we don't need them, need them.
Ahora queremos presentar a un cantante, es ahí, que nos va a venir a dar un poco de su arte.
I'm here to the mission, and something I just want to say really quick before I just get down is, I want to thank each and every one of the people here, including the spirits that are here in San Francisco, specifically in the Mission District. I was born in 1988, so I was raised in the 90s. Hey, what's up? I was raised in the 90s, and I remember I had a tia that used to live out here. Frisco was the only place that provided me with pupusas that reminded me of where I come from. So to that, I want to thank y'all. Frisco is so beautiful. Y'all provide a space for me that reminds me so much of home. But really what I wanted to say is to all my family that's still in Mexico and El Salvador, and to all the families that are out there separated because of these borders, I want to send a lot of love to y'all. There's a lot of people getting killed. And for me, I just want to say one thing is hard to see men like myself talking about emotions that sometimes feel a little bit deep. And something that my elders always taught me was to do things in a sacred manner. So with that being said, I'm going to do a little music with y'all. Is that cool? What's up, Frisco? How y'all feeling? Shout out to Baltimore. You can clap that one. Go ahead. So this song is called I Miss You. If you have anybody that you miss, please think of them right now. Put them in your mind. It goes like this. I love you. Unconditionally hurt you. Say so many fucking things, I think I bust you, I trust you. Never put nothing above you. Immortalize these moments that I'm with you, but fuck you. Cause you killing all my people. Hierarchical status, no one is equal, illegal. No more borders for our heroes.
de celebrate a zero carrera bonita. Mira cada adenita, esquivando tu pulsa, tu pulsa, mi chinga. Frijoles con tortilla, si yo en la silla, we go con lo que lisa. This is the thing that you eating, I'm just thinking through seasons that you've been freezing for reasons. Passing no, don't believe in. The reasons we see this weekend and weekend is freezing. Let me say nothing even. Like a port in the jail, treat them like heathens still breathing. Yes, my heart still beating. Blood out your soul that you're seeing. I miss you, I miss you. What the fuck is the issue? Used to be alive, can't be with you. I ask you, y'all. What the fuck is the issue? Used to be alive, can't be with you. I miss you, I miss you. If y'all miss somebody right now, shout out their name right quick, nice and loud. They can hear y'all. The animals can hear y'all. Rest in peace, Alejandro. Used to be alive, can't be with you, I miss you. I feel everything you touching. Get the world in my palm, none of the judge what you hating. Look at me intimidating. Imitating the little demon who waiting patient. Dark skies never face me. Dark skies never face me. Continue to amaze me. Always be, I miss you. What the fuck is the issue? Used to be alive, can't be with you. I miss you, I miss you. What the fuck is the issue? How y'all feeling out there? Who y'all miss out there? Let me hear you one time. Rest in peace to everybody that passed away. But more than that, we gotta fight like hell for the living, y'all. Straight up. Baltimore, Ferguson, San Francisco, Mexico. At least we're talking right now, y'all. That's a lot of good energy, y'all. I love y'all. Peace and love.
Migration is a human right. Our ancestors have been moving for tens of thousands of years on this land. The phenomenon of calling a human being illegal is extremely new. Think about why you're here, why your family lives in a place like this, from displacement. Economic, systematic violence, which are controlled. This neo-colonial system, European model implemented to control resources and ideology, which maintains the symbolic power. Borders are symbols for real-life consequences. Shout out to my primos in Jalisco and El Salvador. Divide and conquer is the motto. Let's be together, yo.
This is even though 75% of the current jails are pre-trial, and that the city's pre-trial diversion program is being gutted. So basically, people are being locked up for being too poor to pay for bail. This is even though a large percentage of the jail population is held on charges related to mental health and should be receiving care in medical facilities. This is even though the black population of San Francisco is 4% and the black population in the jail is 56%. This is even though it was discovered 4 weeks ago that the sheriff was organizing gladiator matches among those inside of the jail. No, all of this makes it clear that there's no need for a new jail in San Francisco. On top of all of this, San Francisco Board of Supervisors is moving to give $23 million to police departments to run new police academies. The same police department that shot Alex Nieto and many others, and that harassed queer, trans, and street-based people in the shadow of the Monster of the Mission construction project. In the same meeting, the board heard workers that serve the poorest, most disenfranchised communities rallying to demand a $6 million increase for the services that they provide to the community. So now we know that police, as well as jails, are tools of gentrification, facilitating the criminalization, removal, and displacement of poor communities and communities of color. To build strong communities, investments must be made directly in our neighborhoods. The blatant disinvestment in the poorest communities while investing in policing and jail expansion is a slap in the face to those of us who are struggling to continue to make this city a place that's livable. In the wake of the demonstrations of outrage against the prison industrial complex that are erupting across the country, as well as the work that people are doing to build community under the state's constant targeting, San Francisco cannot be tone deaf in its action. As empowered community members organizing to erode the violence that the prison industrial complex creates in our communities, we must recognize this moment of crisis as a moment of weakness in the PIC in San Francisco. We have to act now to demand no new cops and no new jail in San Francisco.
Muchas gracias. Ahora
that's just gotta make some noise. So these cute little people in the front have been passing out flyers for the Hella Undocu Run. It's a 5K run tomorrow at Lake Mary. So today we march, tomorrow we run. The day after that, let's fuck shit up. No, never mind. We'll talk about that later. So real quick, we're about to have some young folks spit a poem for y'all. This piece they've been working on all day. When they were working on it, it sounded like they thought that just maybe if they spit it right, they can knock the border down. And I think that they can, but they need to feel your love. So if you want to knock the border down, make some noise. Like if you really want to knock down that oppressive shit that kills people, make some noise. Okay, now they can spit for y'all. Get ready.
For all the people who question why and why, because we struggle, that's why, to understand my surprise, my contradiction, my happy alongside my pride. You must try to learn that our culture and our pride live alongside a tragic torture of time. Las calaveras y las latrinas on el día de los muertos, masking the pain of white men patrolling borders in nuestros cuerpos. The self-love that was gutted from brown folks who now hide behind brown border patrol uniforms that spark fear in brown eyes of our beautiful brown raza. See, to understand me, we must go back with my gente, back to the land of tears they go, adios. Back to the land of the blood that returns, back to the desert soil that burns, thoughts turn through my head and my heart turns. We live in the ice ages where ice agents don't know raza struggle. They just see cheap labor. They don't know our stories. They just want our day labor. They don't know our past. Brown people just mean green paper. They don't believe in our future. We are unwanted. We commit no harm to this nation, yet we seem to be hunted. But these days are numbered. You see, one day my rebellion raza will rise. We will take back what's ours. No longer will there be deportations, murders on the borders. No longer will pigs kill, beat, take, kick, and rape my people. But until then, let me keep speaking. Let me be wise enough to listen, to hear the stories of how mi gente are tortured, how we die crossing borders, how women like me are raped by executive order.
Anastasia's memory lives forever. His story will be heard. Soon everyone will know that justice is not served. 18 border agents put him to death. They will know he screams, "Ayúdenme!" with his last suffocated breath. Everyone must know the truth behind the system. It isn't meant for me to achieve or become a successful woman. It's meant for me to fail, wind up in a cell, and relive my border trauma, raped and abused in a jail. You may think you are free, but the system also feels mental prison. Selling fake dreams to my people year after year, saying we will be legal. Empty words and deferred action will not make us equal. But I know I'm not alone. We are 11 million strong, and like it or not, we call this land home. Thank you.
One more time, y'all. I don't know what you were doing in your senior year of high school, but I bet it wasn't on point like that, so give it up.
Give it up for 67 Sueños. Thank you for sticking around. We have Bayan USA representing various organizations in the Philippines and all over the world.